Outer Space Adventure is next on Lost in Space. And tonight on Sanford and Son, Aunt Esther and Uncle Woodrow call it quits, and Lamont is having fits. Don't miss the fun at 6. And now a public service message from Channel 32. The March of Dimes SuperWalk. Fun, invigorating, and helping a good cause. Join now and walk together in SuperWalk 1980. This is Field Communications in Chicago. Come and explore America's greatest bargain, your public library, during National Library Week.
Penny, you look like one of those old-fashioned milkmaids coming back from the pasture.
No, it would be good to see a pasture again, walking through the grass, looking for four-leaf clover, waiting...
Off.
You think it's as bad up at the drill site?
I don't think so, but it could be heading their way. I better warn them. Don! Come in, Don! I don't know what's causing this disturbance, but I do know one thing. It's happening at a depth that could crack the core of this planet and lay it wide open. Don, come in, Don!
Right here, John. Listen, that last batch of neutronium fuel tested out just fine. I think we've finally got all we need.
Well, that's good news. How about the earthquake? Give you any trouble?
Earthquake? What earthquake?
We got it here, but good. And deeper than anything we ever had before. You better pack your gear and get back here right away. The next one we hit in your area.
We'll start right back. Judy, get Will and Smith. I'll start loading the equipment.
In the presence of appreciative colleagues and fellow voyagers, I now unveil...
Will! Dr. Smith! We're leaving.
Shh!
Dad just called. He said there might be an earthquake right here in this very area.
Am I or am I not going to receive the reverence this ceremony deserves?
You've got it, Dr. Smith.
As I was saying, William, you too. I now unveil this noble monument. A temple of immortality to the living and imperishable memory of Dr. Zachary Smith. I name thee Spirit of Space.
But Dr. Smith, it doesn't even look like you.
It is the abstract, artistic concept of my inner self.
Now can we leave?
My dear boy, have you no regard for the sanctity of this moment?
We've got to get out of here. Didn't you hear what Judy said? We might be right in the middle of...
You okay?
Oh, how about you?
Your father was almost right. He said the next one may hit in this area. Where's Smith and Will?
They were on the other side of the ridge when it happened.
Come on.
Ah, not even a crack. It will endure forever.
Thank you. Bunch you ever met. What are you after?
Our drill site's up there. That's where we get the fuel for our ship.
And may I add, sir, that we are not addicted to snooping. We were much too involved dedicating my monument.
Mine? Hmm. Beats me why a living man want to fool with, dead stone.
On the contrary, my dear sir, it will outlast us all. Even that earthquake left it completely unharmed.
That was no earthquake. That was me blasting. I'd put up a sign if I'd known I was going to have company. Name's, Nairn. What's yours?
I'm Will Robinson.
Will.
And, I am Dr. Zachary's...
Have you been here long, Mr. Narrow?
Long enough to get my bearings. Hey. I didn't mean any harm.
No offense.
Where do you come from?
Hither and yon in the galaxy of the Southern Fish. Home's catacornered from FOMO Hall, if you know where that is.
Well, I've heard of it.
My dear sir, at the risk of appearing curious, may I ask, what were you blasting for?
Cosmonium.
Cosmonium. I don't believe I've ever heard of it. I don't suppose it's very precious?
Well, it is. If you know how to get it and what to do with it.
Purely out of scientific curiosity, Mr. Nerim, I wonder if we might be allowed to inspect your mining operation. Oh, naturally, we will reciprocate by letting you see our drill site.
Well, I reckon there's no harm. I got the claim all staked. Follow me?
Yes.
Dr. Smith, we've got to get back.
Nonsense, my boy. It's only because they feared we had an earthquake. But when we return, we'll inform them that it was just some of Mr. Nerium's harmless blasting.
Didn't look so harmless to me.
Don't quibble, Will. Come along. Now, sir, where is your mine entrance?
Oh, down there. It ain't a bad little ride. It's been parked, degravitized, so just do as I do.
I don't see him down there.
Neither do I.
Are you coming or ain't you?
Well, we mustn't allow our fear to subdue our scientific curiosity, must we?
Well, then let's go.
What? Oh, my friend, I don't like this at all.
Wow!
Heavens! That wasn't too much of a drop, was it?
How do we get back up?
The same way you got down, sonny. Blow a little air out of your lungs to get you started, that's all. And take off. Hey, you need a heavier boot than you got on to walk around here. I'll sweep them out of the way.
But, Mr. Harry, they're diamonds.
Bang nuisance is all they are to me. No sooner do I sweep one lot out of the way than there's another slew of them dropping down from the ceiling. See what I mean? Now, let's get over here and I'll show you my refining plant. Hey, come on, son.
Mr. Nerim,
Is it possible that what you refine is more precious than diamonds?
You sure ask a lot of fool questions. A man don't go prospecting a dozen light years from home less than it's worth his while. Here, we'll start shoveling ore, Zach boy.
Zach boy, indeed. Will, would you mind? My back is very delicate today. Faster.
Be ready now. Draw some off in a minute.
Aren't you going to an awful lot of trouble just to fill that tiny flask?
Quiet, Will. Good things always come in small doses. Mr. Neri may be in the process of capturing the very quintessence of... Just what is cosmonium the quintessence of, Mr. Neri?
That there is a mighty pretty word, Zach boy. Quintessence is just what this is. Quiet, and here it comes. Two or three of these, and I'll be ready to pull out.
But aren't you going to tell us what its properties are, Mr. Nerim? Oh, I assure you, sir, whatever you care to reveal will be held in the strictest confidence. You have my word of honor on that.
It looks like you've got little bits of sun there, Mr. Nerim.
Don't be ridiculous, Will. What possible use could there be for little bits of sun?
Oh, the boy's smarter than you are, Zach boy. Bits of sun is just about what this is. Quintessence of the living force that thaws the ice and melts the snow and puts a living breath in everything that grows. That's a sight more precious than diamonds, ain't it, Zach boy?
Cosmonium, the quintessence of the living force. It's beyond price.
Beyond any price you could come up with, mister. Well, you boys better get on up top. I got some more blasting to do.
Are you sure that blasting isn't kind of dangerous?
No. Why, I know the geology of this here planet like the back of my hand. A little shaking here and there don't do it no harm. Don't forget to blow out some breath when you're in the shaft.
Oh, Mr. Neri. We shall, of course, meet again.
Can't think of no good reason why we should.
Perhaps I'll think of a reason. Naturally, we shall hold the Tenarium's revelations in the strictest confidence, my boy. I promised, you know.
Blow, Dr. Smith.
Yes.
You gotta kick off.
Oh, yes. Kick off. Like the camels of the desert, we found shelter from the storm in a natural harbor.
Now make like a racehorse at the track. We've got to get back to the ship.
Racehorse indeed, Major. No, no, this way, you blithering bumpkin.
That second quake that you got at the drill site gave us a reading twice as intense as the one we got here. I don't think this planet can stand much more.
Well, John, what will happen to it?
It's the circuit breaker!
Is this what Mr. Nerim calls a little shaking?
It's nothing more than that, my boy. Our fellow voyagers don't seem to have very good sea legs, do they? They're not even good land lovers. There.
It's over. And I think how much cosmonium Mr. Nerin will get after this. Not that I envy him, of course. But what wouldn't I give to have it?
Begin report on seismic disturbance.
Myo-seismal area of shock increasing. Region of seismic focus now distributed over entire planet. Subterranean displacement of geologic structure, total and continuous. Core of planet in condition of molten ferment.
It's worse than I thought.
How bad?
Well, I'm afraid we're on a merry-go-round of chain reaction. In a matter of hours, this planet will cease to exist. It'll disintegrate into cosmic dust.
Cosmic dust, my dear Professor. Cosmic dust, indeed.
Dr. Smith, would you prefer gamma rays?
Ah, well, I don't suppose I'd be betraying too much of confidence if I told you that all of these alarums and excursions are merely the result of some completely harmless detonation set off by a most remarkable mining engineer, my very good friend, Mr. Nerim.
And just where is this very remarkable mining engineer, Dr. Smith? Oh, he's buried.
No, Dad, he's really there. We both saw him. He's got a big excavation down there up near the drill site and lots of equipment for...
For his own private smelting process.
What does he smelt?
You wouldn't understand, my dear, any more than I do. But after all, this is a free planet.
It's a disintegrating planet, Dr. Smith. And regardless of what your very good friend, Mr. Nerim, told you about its detonations being harmless, I'm convinced he doesn't know what he's doing. And he's made it impossible for us to remain here any longer.
Well, can't we stop him from doing any more blasting?
But if we could, darling, it wouldn't do any good. He's begun a destructive process that can't be stopped.
Come, come, Professor. Let's not throw everyone into a tizzy. I can assure you I'm the most reliable authority.
Never mind the reliable authority, Smith. I agree with John. This may be a free planet, but your buddy, whoever he is, has made a condemned world out of it.
How long do we have?
12, 15 hours at the outside. That means all systems have to be go tomorrow morning at 0600, especially the fuel system.
And your destination is where?
Where it's always been, Smith, Alpha Centauri.
Indeed. I might have considered yielding to your panicky pressures if your destination were Earth. But under the circumstances, I can only repeat that your apprehensions are ill-founded. I find this all rather a bore. I think I'll take a nap. Stand aside, please. Thank you.
Doesn't understand a thing you've been telling him.
Now, we'll deal with him later. You better take the children and clear out the light stuff from the camp area. Don and I will take care of the heavy equipment. We're going to have a weight problem for takeoff, so...
Just throw out everything we don't need.
Right.
All right. Come on, children.
We've got work to do.
Do you think we'll be able to make it?
It's really going to be touch and go.
That fearless crusader, Underdog, coming your way today at noon on Channel 32.
Who needs to right this wrong with lightning speed? Goes Underdog,
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 Underdog.
Speed of lightning, power of thunder, fighting all who rob or plunder. Underdog.
Action and fun with Underdog. Today at noon on Channel 32.
Look at the dots as they pop up on your screen. What do you see now? And now? You're right. It's a boat. Creativity is the human resource. It's an ability you can develop, and recognizing patterns is part of it. Test your own creativity in this and a lot of other exciting ways at an exhibit, Creativity, the Human Resource, at the Museum of Science and Industry, Chicago.
Smith!
Oh,
must be tough, that new kid in the neighborhood. But why should we care? We don't know him.
He probably can't play ball anyway.
We don't know him anything. But he sure looks lonely. Wonder how it feels to stand there by yourself. I bet he'd like it if we asked him to play.
So who cares if he's a new kid? Let's invite him in.
Hey, you. You want to play ball? Me? Come on over.
Smiles are friend makers.
Snippets are produced by Field Communications.
Oh, hurry up. You never realize how much stuff you accumulate until you have to get rid of it.
Oh, proving that the acquisitive instinct is still with us. Come on, now help me fold up this table. We're going to need that.
All right. Mom says I have to get rid of all this junk.
Well, that's what you're supposed to do with junk, isn't it?
But it's my own special junk. I'm very fond of it.
Well, maybe if you left the bloop behind, you could take some of it.
Will, how could you?
I was only kidding.
Another one of Dr. Smith's friend's harmless detonations.
No, it was the after effect of all the earlier ones. I studied those ore samples from the drill site. The inner shell of this planet's cracking, releasing the molten iron core. We're going to have to lift off sooner than we planned.
Ready or not?
Oh, we'll be ready. Let's get back to work.
What is all this? Some sort of midnight revel? Hammering, thumping, screeching at the top of your voices, disturbing my nap?
We happen to have a deadline for liftoff, Dr. Smith. Remember?
Oh, that again.
Come on, girls.
Cosmic dust, molten core, and gamma rays. All that bogeyman terminology for scaring children. How tiresome it all is.
Can't you get it through that thick skull of yours, Smith, that this planet is cracking up? And they're worth getting off it before it does.
Oh, yes, Major, cracking up. Another bogeyman word. Well, Godspeed to you, as they say. Is there anything I can do to expedite your departure?
Yes, as a matter of fact, you can take the chariot, go up to the drill site, pick all the equipment up that's lying around, and bring it back here.
Delighted to oblige. As a matter of fact, I was thinking of going over there this evening to have a little chat with my friend, Mr. Nerim, so that in actual fact, I will be killing two birds with one stone, so to speak. May I have the key to the chariot? Thank you, Major. Never fear. Smith is here. Oh, my darling, oh, my dear Cosmonium.
We got us a heap of trouble, Rober. You ain't been gnawing on this here thruster control, have you? Real trouble is what we got, Rober. Blasted too much rock for my own good. This here planet is falling apart, and here we are without no way to get off of it before it does. Uh-oh, looks like we got company. Oh, him again.
Mr. Nerim. Mr. Nerim, my great old friend. I saw your lamp in the window from afar, and I knew your latch string would be out for me.
What are you after now?
But, my dear sir, you misjudge me. Possibly you don't realize it, but I have been your most loyal defender.
You can't defend what ain't been attacked.
But you have been attacked, sir, from all sides. My fellow travelers, or should I say, my ex-fellow travelers, are convinced that because of your blasting, this planet in a matter of hours will disintegrate into cosmic dust. Now, isn't that ridiculous? It is ridiculous, isn't it?
Well, it's the stupidest fool nonsense I ever heard. This here planet has got layers and layers of rock so solid, you could lay a burning sun right on it
and the sun would just burn itself out and leave the planet untouched.
That's exactly what I told them, but they wouldn't listen. They're leaving for Alpha Centauri. Of course, they'll never make it. As a matter of fact, I seriously doubt whether their ship is capable of leaving the ground.
You always get this happy when other folks is in trouble, Zack boy.
But, Mr. Nerim, I feel for them. I do. But they're really not my kind. There's not one among them I could call partner. Partner.
Are you aiming to be my partner?
Nothing would please me more. Prospecting is in my blood, you see. My great-great-grandfather was a 49er, and my Uncle Thaddeus discovered the Comstock Lode all by himself. Of course, they were only after mere gold. Not anything as priceless as cosmonium. They never would have understood its worth as we do. Eh, partner?
I've got to be honest with you, Zacky. I've been a loner most of my life, and I'm getting too old to change now. This little poke of cosmonium is about the last of the diggings for me. It's gonna be like my pension fund. If I ever get back home. But don't look like I ever will now.
Why not?
Busted thruster control on my spaceship. I'd give anything for a spare. Even gamble with my pension fund.
You would? You would gamble with this priceless substance?
Most of it, I reckon. If I had to. Oh, but what's the use? No one's gonna bet with me.
Well, be of good cheer, my friend. The sky is always darkest just before the dawn. Huh? Every cloud has a silver lining.
It does?
Yes. And it's an ill wind that blows nobody any good. I may return.
Mother, about 3 hours at the most, according to your father.
Ah, how doth the little busy bee improve each shining hour?
Dr. Smith, we are not bees, and there is nothing very shining about 3 o'clock in the morning. We just all happen to have a very sensible instinct for self-preservation.
Sensible, madam. I don't wish to sound discouraging, dear lady, but the chances of the Jupiter 2 being able to budge from this spot are roughly 1,000 to 1 against. I can assure you without fear of contradiction that this planet, like the Jupiter itself, is here to stay.
Roll them, partner. Roll the dice. Quintessence of the living force. Take one drop at bedtime and live forever.
Oh, Dr. Smith, do you still think this planet is here to stay?
Indubitably, madam.
Madam.
Will, can you get me the soldering kit, please?
Sure, dear.
Why not face it, gentlemen? I'm afraid that all the king's horses and all the king's men will never put Jupiter together again.
You want to bet?
I'd be stealing your money, Major.
Smith, if you haven't anything more constructive to contribute, get outside and unload the chariot.
That's really what I came in to talk to you about, Professor. My mission was a failure. I lost my way.
You lost your way. You've been up there 100 times.
But never in the dark.
Here, Dad.
Thank you.
Means losing a couple of hours of my working here if I go up now. Maybe we better just forget it.
No, some of that equipment may be vital to us, if and when we land on Alpha Centauri.
Maybe I should go with him, Dad. I've been up there at night.
All right, Dr. Smith.
You can go back up there with Will. But regardless of how you feel about such bogey words as cosmic dust, I want you both back here within 2 hours at the outside.
Your wish is my command, sir.
We're almost there, Dr. Smith. I thought you said you didn't know your way in the dark.
But did I? Well, perhaps my eyes have grown accustomed to the darkness by now.
There's a turnoff.
Later, my boy, later. I have a little something to deliver to Mr. Nerim. The poor man needs a spare part for his ship.
You can't give him that. That's a thruster control. Where'd you get it?
No cause for alarm, my dear boy. I found it on the junk pile. Ah, here we are. There. Yes.
I don't see why you have to play cards with Mr. Nerim, Dr. Smith. Why don't you just give him...
Mr. Nerim is a proud and conscientious man. His pride will not allow him to accept charity.
That's right, son. Never accepted no charity in my whole life. I'd rather gamble with my life savings than do that.
He means his cosmonium. What a brave man he is.
And you'd take it?
Only if I won it. As many as slip twixt the cup and the lip. Now, sir, shall we cut for deal?
A ten of galaxies. And all I've got is a deuce of asteroids. Looks like you're starting out lucky, Zach boy.
Galaxies? Asteroids? I don't believe I understand these cards.
Well, there's nothing to understand. Galaxies is the big ones. Then planets, then satellites, all the way down to asteroids.
Hey, Dr. Smith, I think we'd better get out of here.
Nothing to worry about. Just a little resettling, and that's all. Looser deals, right, Zach boy?
Yes, of course.
What you got, Zach boy?
Well, well. Galaxies. A pair. I believe you said they were the highest.
Mighty good. And always a winner. Except when somebody else has got a supernova.
Supernova? You mean I lost?
You can't win them all, Zach.
It's all right, Dr. Smith. You said you wanted to lose, remember?
Of course. How can I forget? Aren't you going to give me a chance for revenge?
Well, I don't need nothing but this. Besides, I got to get out of here. I ain't got no time. It looks like your friends was right about this planet. It ain't gonna be nothing but cosmic dust pretty quick.
What? It can't be. You told me?
Well, I guess my calculations went to my cave wire.
Now look here, Mr. Nerim. Mr. Nerim? Mr. Nerim, you come right back here.
That's the way the planet crumbles.
Perfectly. Up the knife. Oh, the pain. The pain.
Never mind about that, Dr. Smith. Didn't you hear what he said? We've got to get out of here.
My dream shattered, the quintessence of the living force gone forever.
Look! He left these two flasks. We'd better return them to him.
No hurry, my boy, no hurry. Well, it wasn't a total loss after all, was it?
I'm not sure what you mean by that, Dr. Smith. But if we don't get out of here, it's us who are going to be a total loss.
Oh, no, no, we can't let that happen. Now that this priceless treasure has been bestowed upon me.
Oh, dear. Oh. his cosmonia.
You don't sound too unhappy about that, Dr. Smith. Let's get back to the drill song.
Will, my monument, oh! Oh, dear. It was so proud and imperishable.
We'd better go, Dr. Smith.
Will, help me to set it right.
What's the use? It can't last anyway.
Despite your misgivings, my monument will endure forever, in one position or another. My cosmonium! Will, help me! Help me to scoop it up.
Dr. Smith, we're leaving at 0600, and that's less than 3 hours from now. And we still got to get the drilling equipment.
Yes.
And you?
Come, Will.
Good times and Tennessee Tuxedo today at 12:30 on Channel 32.
All right, Chumley, plug it in. We'll show that Stanley Livingston. This is going to electrify the zoo. Chumley.
You never know what to expect with Tennessee Tuxedo. Join the fun today at 12:30 on Channel 32.
This is the legend of Lightning Jones. No one's ever seen the shoes he owns. Some say they're blue and some say they're red. It's even been said that some say they're Keds.
Keds?
You'll never run as fast as Lightning Jones, even if you had Keds of your own.
Keds?
Cause Lightning's a phantom just showing his heels. And even though he's not for real, one thing is true. There's really a Keds. You could wear him too.
Keds are available at these fine stores. Funny, friendly, Magilla Gorilla. Joining your after-school fun today at 2:30 on Channel 32.
I sure didn't know my hospital plan was good up here.
Amazing. Do you see what I see, Doctor? Yes, it's hard to believe. But it's a peanut.
TV's funniest monkey, Magilla Gorilla, today at 2:30 on Channel 32.
You know, growing up is tough. For kids to make it, they need a fighting chance, like the one I got at the Boys Clubs of America. The Boys Clubs stay open to give kids a place to go and a chance to make friends. The clubs are run by trained adults with a lot of heart and time to listen. I'm glad I had a Boys Club. And so are a million kids today, because growing up is still tough, and kids don't have a fighting chance without a good club.
On November 30th, 1979, WFLD-TV was granted a license by the Federal Communications Commission to serve the public interest as a public trustee until December 1, 1982. Each August 1, we place in our public inspection file a list of what we consider to have been some of the significant problems and needs of our service area during the preceding 12 months, and some of our programming aired to help meet those problems and needs. We invite viewers to send specific suggestions or comments concerning our station operation and programming efforts to WFLD-TV, 300 North State Street, Chicago, Illinois, 60610. Unless otherwise requested, all letters received will be available for public inspection during regular business hours.
Is this really necessary, my boy? Major West himself said he was perfectly willing to forget all of this drilling equipment.
Dad said we may need it on Alpha Centauri.
Then why did we have to leave the chariot so far away?
Dad said we had to conserve fuel.
Oh, the pain, the pain. Alpha Centauri, of all places, when Earth is so close, he'll never make it. I really must have a very serious talk with him.
He won't listen to you.
Why not?
You've made too many mistakes lately. First you said the blasting was harmless, and then you said the planet would never break up.
Indeed. Must a man be haunted by a few trivial errors in his past?
It's alive!
I think it wants something.
Give him a jewel kiss!
Trying to raise them by radio.
I'll do the same.
Roger.
I'll keep in touch with you as well. All right, stand clear.
Hi, Dad. John, you've got to find them, even if it means...
Yes, even if it means delaying our liftoff. Don't worry.
Area. Come in if you see me. Will, report your position.
Thank you.
Will, I should never have listened to you and given him my cosmonium. I'm sure I could have persuaded him to leave without it in another moment or two. Here, give me a hand.
Dr. Smith, in another moment or two, you wouldn't have been around to do anything.
Neither will any of us if we don't get back to that ship in a hurry. Let's go!
Are we ready?
Ready as well, I think.
All right. Liftoff's in 5 minutes. I wasn't entirely sure until now. I don't need any more proof after this. I'll make one last check below. Smith?
Over here. Smith is here.
What have you got there?
My motion sickness remedy.
All right, take it and get in the chair.
Cheers. Oh. I don't suppose there's anything more I could say that would make you change your mind about our destination.
Oh, we're not going to go through all that again now, are we, Doctor?
You realize, of course, that no human eye has ever seen Alpha Centauri.
All buckled up?
We can't even be sure that it's habitable.
I'm well aware of that, Doctor.
In that case, I strongly urge that we change our course for a place that we know really exists.
Get in that chair, Smith, and buckle your seatbelt. All secure?
Robot in magnetic lock. I will maintain myself in magnetic lock until further orders.
Ah, that's a thrilling bit of news, you bumbling bird brain.
Well, the children are all ready.
Fine. Now we'll go into orbit at minimum apogee. And remain in orbit around this planet until, well, until there is no planet. After that, we'll be free of gravitational pull and on our way. Couch belts will remain fastened until I give the order that they be removed. Understood?
Yes.
Now, we may not be able to communicate with each other for a little while, Penny, so is there anything you'd like to ask me?
Is Debbie gonna be all right?
Oh, she'll be just fine.
Dad? Are you sure you're not going to need me to help out on top?
Well, it's going to be a tough job, but Don and I will do the best we can.
And don't worry about Dr. Smith. I'll take care of him.
What a comfort you are in my hour of need.
Judy, you look simply beautiful.
Thank you, Dad.
What? What's that for?
Well, because I'm so proud of you. And because you've taken such good care of us. And because I love you.
Oh, yes, there's something I forgot to tell you. You've been the most uncomplaining, patient partner a man could wish for while we've been here. Thank you, darling.
Been a very good reason for it. You.
You just have time to strap up.
Will disintegrate into cosmic dust. If the professor's predictions are accurate, disintegrate indeed. Ah!
3 second burst on five.
Roger. No power. It's starting to roll. We can't pull free of the planet's gravity.
Our pal Woody Woodpecker will be on the scene to share a great half hour of cartoon fun today at 4. Woody Woodpecker. Today at 4 on Channel 32, The Kid's Choice.
Enter into the world of nighttime hunters, where the lynx bounds across Rocky Mountain crags, where fishing cats plunge into a jungle pool for food. Something new at the wildest place around, Brookfield Zoo's Predator Ecology Exhibit. Bring the family for a free guided tour through this exciting addition to the Lion House at Brookfield Zoo.
Wow!
Wildest place around.
Snippets are produced by Field Communications.
We're getting the heat feedback. The thrust is canceling pull.
Try a 5-second burst on the main bank again.
Roger, here goes.
Junk pile. Dr. Smith gave it to that old mining engineer.
If only I hadn't done it. It's all up with us now because of me. I didn't find it on the junk pile. I found it on a central astrolator.
Well, I think you better get right up there and tell them what you did.
I can't do it now. I'm strapped in.
Well, then unstrap and get right up there.
If you insist.
Will, I think you'd better go up with him.
Yes, ma'am.
Bear me out, won't you, Will, when I tell them that I meant no harm. It was just a vagrant impulse.
You have to explain that yourself. I don't know what a vagrant impulse means.
What are you doing up here? You had strict orders.
Dr. Smith has something to tell you, Don.
What is it?
Nothing at all. That is, if you're able to repair what appears to be wrong.
So far, no luck.
You'd better tell him, Doctor.
I only did it out of the goodness of my heart.
Did what?
Donated one of our thruster controls to Mr. Nerin. The one that was there.
Oi.
Hold on, the planet's blowing!
Finally on our way.
Good.
Hey,
So out of the goodness of your heart, you nearly signed all our death warrants.
Except his own, naturally. He was quite sure that all the king's horses and all the king's men couldn't put the Jupiter back together again.
Believe me, Major, I have the deepest admiration for your remarkable ingenuity. And nothing pleases me more than to be proved wrong.
You sure know how to change your mind fast, Dr. Smith.
When circumstances demand it, my boy.
Well, I take it that Dr. Smith explained what he did.
Well, darling, Dr. Smith's explanations are like a box of magic tricks.
Mom! Dad! Come here! Quick! The Nova Flare. Oh, it looks like a rainbow after a storm.
After the storms we've been through, I think we're entitled to it.
Oh! I think I see a familiar planet out there.
That's not a planet, Dr. Smith. That's a red dwarf star.
For a moment, I thought it might be...
Forget about it, Smith. Whatever you thought it might be, we happen to be pulling away from it at about 50% of light velocity.
Light velocity? Oh, dear. I can feel my motion sickness coming back. Oh, the pain. The pain.
The Brady Bunch is fun for the whole family. Tune in today at 5 on Channel 32.
Mom's gonna have a baby!
A baby?
Are you sure?
May I never read a comic book again?
Are you sure?
Hey, don't tell Mom I told you, huh?
Okay. What do you know?
Wow, a baby! Here, I can't practice at a time like this. I'm an expectant brother.
Laughter and good times with the Brady Bunch today at 5 on Channel 32.
Cheerios!
How'd they get up there?
Yummy Odios!
Whoops!
Cheerios. Crunchy, yummy Odios. Toasted for extra crunchiness. Extra goodness in every yummy spoonful. Cheerios. The tasty part of this nutritious breakfast.
Cheerios!
When you want Whoops. The great taste of Cheerios...
Cheerios!
Just Cheeriodle.
Today at 5:30, Richie's new friend has some weird table manners.
Would you please pass the roast beef, Deidre?
Sure. She fainted.
Okay, so she doesn't have to pass the roast beef.
Then at 6, Esther and Woody are at it again.
When you talk to that worm Woodrow, you tell him his behind is grass. And I am the lawnmower.
The Brady Bunch at 5. Happy days again at 5:30. Sanford and Son at 6. Tonight on Channel 32.
Energy crisis, pollution, inflation. Some people no longer just talk about these problems, they're doing something about them. Throughout the country, people are gardening, recycling, installing solar collectors, switching to efficient transportation. They're working for a future we can live with. That's what Earth Day is about. Earth Day. Join us in celebrating community efforts to create a workable tomorrow. Earth Day, April 22nd.
Closer to 2 million, son.
Wow, we must be traveling at close to speed of light.
Just about, Will.
What a pity we have no idea where we're traveling to.
We'll know once we spot a familiar star and get a fix on it.
The trouble is, there are billions of stars out there, and they all look familiar.
He's right. I can't tell one from the other. Of course not, silly. You don't know anything about astronomy. But Dad does, and so does Don.
That is devoutly to be wished. Howsomever, I think I shall do a little stargazing on my own.
You mean you're going to take another nap?
Spare me the barbs, Major. Just remember they laughed at Copernicus, too. You, sir, come with me.
And you, come with me, my dear.
I want to stay here with Dad and Don. They may need my help.
Not as much as I do.
Holy cow!
Now, let's see. Earth should be back here.
John, maneuver around it!
Dr. Don, and guess what? Underdog is next. Remember, 90 minutes of laughs waiting for you at 5 o'clock today, right after Tom and Jerry. The Brady Bunch. Then at 5:30, it's Richie, the Fonz, and the Happy Days Again gang, followed by Sanford and Son at 6. All your favorites on Channel 32.